Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at viewing and organizing your photos in the new Photos app. So in the new Photos app, there are two main ways to view your photos. The first is in Photos mode, which just allows you to view everything in chronological order, grouped together by either the date or location. The second way is to view albums that you create yourself. So let's first start with the Photos mode. And there are three different levels to photos. The top level here is called Years, and that things are arranged by years, grouped together. So here you can see that 2014, 2015 are grouped together because I don't have very many photos yet for 2015. You can see here I've got forward and backward arrows, just like you do in a web browser. And I'm at the top level here, so I can't go up any further from Years, but I can go down into what are called Collections. You can see it zooms in there, and now the years are broken up into smaller groups by date range and area. And I can go even deeper here to go into Moments, and Moments breaks it up into individual days pretty much and gives you locations here as well. So I can go back and forth fluidly between these. Now in any one of these views I can tap and hold or click and hold on my Mac and I get this larger preview and I can kind of go back and forth between them. It makes a lot more sense here in Years where you can barely see the photos, so you can quickly go there. Now if I release my finger off of the trackpad it will jump right to editing that photo. Also you can see here I've got the locations. If I wanted to I could tap or click on the location there and you can see it brings up a map and shows me groups of photos by location. Now what will be left out here is photos that were taken with my larger camera, not my iPhone, because there's no location information there. And I can go to satellite and hybrid view here, just as you can in the Maps app. I can even do 3D and I can zoom in and out. So a lot of things you can do there with the maps. You can also get a map view here at down at this view as well, so you can see even closer. If you take all your pictures with your iPhone or if you've got a camera that's GPS in it, this is even more useful because every location of every photo is shown on the different maps. Now there's really no customization here to the Photos view. It is just one long list of every photo we have in your collection and it allows you to quickly zoom in to find a photo based on the date or the location. So if you are an organizer and want to put your photos together in different collections of your own devising, then you really want albums. Albums, if you click on that, will take you to here and show you some albums that already has set up. Like for instance, it'll put all your panoramas in a single album. It also has the faces functionality, and once you identify some faces in your photos, you can quickly look at a collection of photos that has a certain person in them. And then you've got your albums, the albums that you've created, and you can create regular albums or smart albums. And once you've done that, then you can go into these. And these don't have to have all your photos in them. They can just have a small collection of say your favorite photos or photos that have to do with one thing or the other. Keep in mind that your photos are only there once. They're in this one big collection of photos. Albums are kind of like playlists in iTunes where they're just basically another way of viewing the photos you have. So because you see a photo in an album here and it's also here doesn't mean you have it twice. You only have it once. This is just kind of a playlist of them. You can also have one photo in multiple albums. So for instance you can have an album of some of your favorite photos and an album of photos of a trip that you took and have the same photo in both albums. Just like playlists handle songs in iTunes. Now let's create a new album. There are a couple ways to do this. You can go to the File menu and choose New Album. Now if you have some pictures selected, you say you're looking in Photos view here and you select some photos and you say New Album, it will start off with these photos in there. So let's go ahead and do that and we'll give it a name. And now it doesn't look like anything's happened, but if we go over to the Albums collection here we can see there's our test album. We can go into it and find those photos there. So now the question is how do you add to this? Well there are a lot of different ways to add to an album. One way is to return to the Photos view and select some more photos. So let's select these two right here. And I can hit the plus button here and add them to an album. And I can select the album I want to add them to. So it'll add this to test album. Now when I look here I can see Test Album has those extra photos in there. You can also bring up the sidebar, and the sidebar starts to make the Photos app look a little bit more like the old iPhoto app here. And you can see the Test Album there. And this is the way I like to do it, because I could go and go to Photos. Notice that those buttons are gone at the top here, and I can actually switch to things on the left. So I can go to Photos and I could select another image, say this one here, and simply drag and drop it into Test Album. So this is kind of how I like to do it. And I can switch the Test Album very easily, switch back to Photos very easily. So how about deleting photos? So you can select photos in an album here non-consecutively holding the Command key down, or arrange holding the Shift key down. And this is only in the album here. I'm not looking in Photos. So when I delete here, it's going to delete it from the album, but the original will still remain there. The way to do a lot of things here is to use the Control click or two-finger click on the trackpad, whatever your alternate click is, and then you get a lot of commands here, like for instance, remove from album. I like how it's very clear here saying it's going to remove these from the album, not delete them from your collection. So like let's just select one here and remove from album, and it's gone from the album. You could also reorder the photos in an album by just dragging and dropping them around. So Photos caters to a lot of different types of people in terms of how you want to organize things. There may be people that don't use albums at all and just like all their photos just in chronological order here. And there may be people that create an album for everything that they do and basically never look at the Photos view and only look at their photos and albums. And there'll be people like me that kind of do a mix of both.